Hey, hello there, guys. Broxens here, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. So in the previous episode, we entered the Zora's Domain, and we also took on the shrine right below us here. And now we are going to go up here to the king of the Zora's Domain. But before we do that, I want to talk to this dude here. Hello and welcome. Zora's Domain is currently searching for a Hylian like you. That said, this Hylian, I get the feeling I've seen him before. Perhaps a long time ago. Okay, just wanted to see what they said. I'm gonna check out this dude as well. Oh, a Hylian, eh? The path to Zora's Domain is paved with monsters, is it not? Here in the Domain, we are currently recruiting warriors to join Prince Sidon in his fight. Please hurry and meet with him. Okay, gonna do that right now. Reach Zora's Domain. Complete. Okay, I believe this is going to be a cutscene here. So, let's see. We're just walking up. And is it a cutscene? Or are we just talking to him?
Ah, you must be the Hylian that Sidon brought here, correct? You did well to come all the way here. I am King Dorophan, ruler of the Zora. That object upon your waist, is that not a Sheikah Slate? Now that I've gotten a good look at you, it is all too clear who you are. You are the Hylian Champion, Link. Don't tell me you have forgotten me. The Hylian Champion? You can't mean the Link? That champion? So that's where I've heard your name before. What a fateful coincidence that we should cross paths. I cannot believe it. The Hylian Champion Link has appeared before us. We have met him numerous times. I'll have you know. So many memories. My mind is overflowing with nostalgia, my friend. I had heard a terrible rumor that you had fallen in combat, but it appears you managed to survive. Extraordinary. I lost my memory. Let me say that. Come again? You say you have lost your memory? But surely you must remember my precious daughter Mipha, yes? You do you not? I'll go with Mipha who? I cannot believe it. Have you truly forgotten my dear Mipha as well? You and Mipha were so close, yet you do not remember her. Young hero, please look upon the beauty of Zora's Domain. Do you see that statue? Does gazing upon Mipha's immortalized form still not jog your memory? Not really. Well, perhaps your memory will return in time. I dearly hope so. Father, I do not believe discussing my sister is helping matters at the moment. Link seems confused. Oh, yes, of course. But first, it is worth noting how remarkable it is that Sidon brought a champion here without realizing it. That is quite a feat, my boy. Wahaha, that is a good one. Link, I doubt not that you have endured a great many trials. Still, I must ask you to hear my plea. Now then, hero, I must inform you that Zora's Domain is in danger of vanishing because of the divine beast, Varuta. I shall do you the courtesy of speaking bluntly. We alone cannot stop the beast. Will you lend us your strength? What? King Dorophan, my liege, please do not speak so. To ask a Hylian for help, why, the very thought of it curls my fins. Muzu, I expect more of you. How can you still protest? Muzu, it is rude to speak that way to your king and his guest. Link here is here because I invited him. With such unprecedented rainfall, we have no choice but to rely on the aid of a trustworthy Hylian. Have we not already discussed this and arrived at that very conclusion? He is the key... can't even talk. He is the key to saving Zora's Domain. I have no doubt in my mind. Indeed, Link is a champion. Through and through. As things now stand, Zora's Domain, nay, perhaps all of Hyrule, is doomed to be swallowed by the sea. This is bigger than all of us, my friend. Zoras and humans alike must... Hylians alike must put aside our differences and band together. Have you forgotten already, my king? We cannot trust these lowly Hylians. 100 years ago, they abused the power of an ancient civilization and turned Hyrule into what it is today. And that is not the least of it. Okay, this dude's obviously annoyed. What did I do to you, man? I'm just trying to save the world. It is their fault that Lady Miffa was lost to us. Link. Divine Beast Varuta has great power. It has the unique ability to create an endless supply of water. Of late, it has been mercilessly spouting water in the air. As a result, this area has been plagued by heavy rainfalls. For us Zora, water and air are as one. So you would not think this would be quite so critical of a problem. Sadly, the rainfalls have filled the eastern reservoir nearly to the point of flooding. If the reservoir bursts, as it soon will, I fear immense danger will befall not only Zora's domain, but also the area downstream from us. Their Hylian lives are in very grave danger. What was that noise? The divine beast is calling out once again. Okay, I'm gonna go and fight this thing, aren't I? Oh no. That is mildly frightening. It's an elephant. It's a giant elephant. Awesome! Let's go and do something about this. The Divine Beast Varuta. Your Princess Zelda often studied the Divine Beast. That is, in the time before the Great Calamity. According to her research, the orbs located on Ruta's shoulders are mechanisms that can control the water it generates. However, they require electricity to work. The orbs are clearly out of control now because there is no electricity coursing through to stop them. Segan, who was quite shock-resistant for Azora, hit one with a shock arrow. Sure enough, it slowed the water a bit. Unfortunately, as an aquatic race, we Zora are terribly vulnerable to electricity. Perhaps because we could not safely strike it with enough electricity at once, the water soon returned to its full force. And that is why I went in search of a Hylian who could help us. Link, I'm certain you already figured this out, but we need you to use shock arrows to get those orbs working properly again. I will aid you in any way I can, of course. Please, Hero, I beg of you, help me stop Ruto's rampage of destruction. What? Princess Zelda herself instructed you to board the Divine Beast and appease it from within? So then Princess Zelda is still alive? Yes, in Hyrule Castle. I do not believe it. She was alive this whole time, just as you were. The events of 100 years ago cannot be altered, it is true. But if we can regain control of the Divine Beast, they may yet prove useful in sealing Calamity Ganon once and for all. I did not know you had such grand ambitions, Link. Wondrous, naturally, I shall help too. Once it has stopped rampaging, you can easily climb inside. Come, Link, let's appease Ruta together. I'm in. Let's do this! Let's go and fight this thing! Thank you, Link, truly. We are in your debt. Our goal is the same. That means our meeting was nothing short of destiny. Now then, allow me to offer you this gift as a show of faith. Ooh, that is nice. King Dorophan, surely you do not intend to give this outsider the Zora armor. Countless generations of Zora princesses have gifted that armor to the one they have sworn to marry. Princess Miffa made that one there with her own hands. It is far too important to entrust to a shady Hylian. He may be the champion, but Miffa had no such relationship with him, so why should he receive such an honor? This is just too much, my liege. I do not understand it one bit. That Muzu is not easily swayed once his mind is set. You must understand, he was in charge of educating my dear daughter Miffa. Naturally, she means a lot to him, just as she means the world to us. Ever since we lost her to the Calamity, he has grown to despise Hylians. I hope you can forgive his rudeness. Yeah, I can forgive him. But what shall we do now? I tasked Muzu with finding the shock arrows we need to appease Varuta. But now he has rushed off in a huff. Link, do not let his words concern you. I will work this out with Muzu. I shall return shortly. Okay. Sidon, I suppose that means you are going to tell him. Link, Muzu is most likely at the square down below. Would you mind going down there? I would like you to try to speak with him. Sure. Sure, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's jump down here. Okay. Alright. Hey, dude. How's it going? How's it going? You came all the way down here, but it was in vain. I have no desire to speak with you. Listen well, Muzu. There is something you need to know. He who stands here is the man called Link. It's the one whom my sister Mipha had feelings for. I was only a child then, so I did not know it myself at the time, but it is so. I grew up hearing my father tell stories, some of which were about my sister's undying love for a Hylian named Link.
Okay, then. That's interesting.
What? No. You cannot fool me with such a fanciful lie. Not this, Zora. How could Lady Mipha possibly have feelings for a Hylian like him? The facts are clear. He remembers nothing, even when he looks upon Princess Mipha's statue. It is the truth, Muzu. Though you never knew it, he was ever in Mipha's heart. Wow. Wow. Am I gonna remember something here? Am I gonna remember something? Okay, so Link just had a memory of the past, and it was a memory of him with Mipha, and they were on the Divine Beast, and Mipha was healing him up, and she said that she would always heal him up no matter what, no matter if he got, like, hurt or anything like that. And then she said, maybe once this is all over, like, the whole Calamity Ganon thing, they can go back to, like, how it was before that, you know, spending some time together, and it was interesting. It was interesting. It was a very interesting scene there. Anyways, let's see here. What's the matter, Link? Are you unwell? You are quivering like a hatchling. Whatever is the matter? Mipha, I remember. What? Do not mistake me for a fool, Hylian. There's no way you remembered her just now, when it is most convenient. In any case, without solid proof, I cannot possibly take you at your word. If you have any such proof, now is the time to show it. Do so, and I shall tell you how to get those shock arrows. How am I supposed to prove it? Without any solid proof. How do I prove it? How do you expect me to prove it to you? Maybe if I have the silver longsword? If I'm truly her beloved, prove it. I have an idea. This should work. Muzu, look closely at the clothes Link is wearing. You really think changing your clothes is going to make me... Huh? What in the... That's the Zora armor from before. Lady Mipha made that by hand, and yet it fits you perfectly. What is the meaning of this? Now you understand, do you not? Do you know who her heart belonged to? Now you know who her heart belonged to and who she made that special armor for. The fact that it fits Link perfectly should be proof enough that Mipha made it for him and him alone. You have always disliked Hylians, even before the Great Calamity. That is why Mipha never told you. Now that you know, you must promise to help us save us all. Muzu, please, tell us where we can find the shock arrows we need. Knowing you, I bet you've already figured it out. I never would have imagined she would make the special armor for someone such as he. So now what? Now what, Muzu? What are you gonna do? I do not approve of asking for help from a Hylian, but I suppose it is our only option at this point. I'm a proud Zora. That means I must take responsibility for my unwarranted behavior towards you. As promised, I shall tell you where to collect as many shock arrows as you will need. And that tall mountain over yonder, it's called Plymouth Mountain, and there you'll also find Shatterback Point. A terrifying creature has made its home up there. The awful beast shoots volley after volley of shock arrows. Even a single one could be fatal to Zora. Uh-huh. You must mean that Lionel. He's a man-beast, that one. That beast does indeed wield shock arrows. That is certainly one way to collect them quickly. He is vicious, to be sure, but I am certain Link will rise to the challenge. In order to appease the divine beast, you'll need, at least 20 shock arrows. Do you think you can gather that many? Why do you still doubt him, Muzu? I have no doubt he'll triumph. Okay, Link, let's get moving. The fastest way to Plymouth Mountain is to ascend the waterfall to the east of the domain. The Zora armor should come in handy. Just swim to the waterfall basin and then just up the waterfall from there. I'll wait at East Reservoir Lake, right by the Divine Beast. Gather at least 20 shock arrows, and then come join me. I'm on it. I hope it gives me a little marker. Or at least shows me a better sight of where to go. Okay, map objective is, okay, it's on the mountain. That is good. So let me go up here, since there is a way to get out of here while being up here. Grab that crab. You're not getting away from me, buddy. You're a wonderful source of food. Of course I'm gonna keep you. Grab the crab. Okay, we're gonna need to head up here, so let me run and jump. There we go, and now let's go around here. And we should be able to get over to this mountain. Hopefully we are able to. Okay, let's see here. You know, the interesting thing is like, the fact that the elephant is placed in the reservoir. I mean, it's not really that great of a location to place it. Not sure why you placed it there. Yes, sir. East Gate is all clear, sir. Well, if it isn't Master Link, you are a sight for sore eyes. We used to play together all the time. That was 100 years ago. My name is Gaddison. The Hylian that Prince Sidon brought here. Don't tell me that was you, Master Link. And what's more, you don't seem to have changed much in the past 100 years. Oh, but I shouldn't be making idle chit-chat just now. I'm supposed to be fulfilling my official appointed duty by keeping watch at the East Gate. Okay, we can chat later. Okay, talk to you later then. So, let's see here. This should tell us where to go. Shortcut to Plymouth Mountain. Or Plymouth Mountain. Whatever it's called. Let's just go to it. You know? Ooh, grab that mushroom there. And now let me make sure I have all my stamina. And then we have to climb this. Okay. Oh, wow. Wow, we can swim really fast. That is crazy. That was crazy fast. And we didn't even use any stamina. Yo. That's kind of cool. Whoa. And come on, do more tricks. It's very cool. Very, very cool. Anyways, let's jump up here. And I don't think it's going to be over here, but it's going to be one more, like, level up here. So let me grab some stuff real quick. What's this? Nothing too interesting. Ooh, I did hear something. I have a feeling that is the creature up there. Ooh, ducks. How's it going? Anyways, let's swim upward. Jump. And jump. And keep jumping, because it's cool. Okay. Looks like we've made it up to the top. But now the question is, how do I make it to that creature? That creature we must face. Ooh. Well, we've got a shock arrow now. So we know where to go. Generally, at least. Let me save my game real quick. Okay. Just because I want to make sure that if we do stumble upon this creature right now, that we are mildly prepared to actually take it on. Okay, Shatterback pointing this way. Okay, let's be ready with this. Ooh, we got a Cold Darner. Okay. Where is this thing? There it is. There it is. So we need 20 arrows. And we also definitely need to take this thing down. So let's go. Okay, buddy. Buddy. Oh, dang. Dang, that kind of hurt. That kind of hurt. That just kind of hurt. Well, that. Let's try again. Let's try again. Oh, boy. This is going to be fun. This is most definitely going to be fun to try and take this thing down. So, best course of action. Hide from the thing. Grab the arrow. Save the game. Just save the game. You're about to die anyways. Okay. Okay, grab the shock arrow. Ooh, no, you can be nice. You know, the reason I'm saving my game a bunch is because there's a bunch of stuff going down here. Oh, hi. How do you do? How do you do? Okay. Ooh, he doesn't even have that much health. That's good. Save the game and run. Or not. Luckily, I did save the game there, so now we're gonna get put back. Okay. So I know how the game said we need at least 20 arrows, but there's no way I'm gonna be able to do anything with just 20 arrows. So I have to try to do a little bit better than that. And I've also got to try and take this thing down. Careful. Be very careful. Grab that. Run! Gosh darn it. Oh, man. This dude is powerful. This dude is definitely powerful. I don't know if it'd be better if I tried to take him down, or if it'd be better if I just try to avoid him as much as possible. I think in the long run, it's going to be easier to just take him down. So, let's see here. Jump down. Okay. Right. Run. How the heck are you so good with a bow? What is this dude? He's like... just... Bowmaster 9000. Bowmaster 9000 here with his super amazing bow skills that we don't have because we suck at this game. I mean, we don't actually suck at this game. We're just bad. Right. I think it's time to bring out the big guns. Oh, dang. You took me down pretty easily. I applaud you for that. Nicely done, buddy. Nicely done, buddy. We're gonna take this dude down. We're gonna destroy this dude. Now that I'm using my royal bow, which I am really hesitant to use, I don't want to use it. I really, really don't want to use it, but now that we are using it, We can easily take this dude down. Okay. Step over to the side. Okay. Run. Okay. I dropped my controller there because, holy cow. Rather, holy man on a body of a horse. But he's not really a man, he's like a weird demonic creature. Why wasn't I warned that this was going to be insane? I mean, they did say, hey, might be a bit difficult. Didn't really mention it was going to be insanely difficult. No. Run. Get as far away as possible. What am I supposed to do? Dang it. I mean, I think it'd just be better if I avoid him as much as possible now. And get all the shock arrows that I can that are here in the distance. So, let's try that. There's 4 shock arrows there. What's this? Jump at your own risk. Oh, okay. So that's how I can get down to the Divine Beast. Let me save my game real quick. We've got 9. So we're gonna need 11 more, but I want to try and get as many as possible. And I do also want to try and take them down. Careful. Careful. He can see us. Also, let me change my bow real quick. Have the royal bow ready. Okay. Carefully go over here. Grab this one. Okay, we've almost got enough. We've almost got enough. Okay, is there one over here? Be careful. Be very careful. That is what matters here. As long as we're careful, he shouldn't be able to get us here. And if he does get close to us, I'll just save the game and, you know, let him take us down. I think that's the best course of action if he does have the ability to take us down anyways. Because if he can do it, then we might as well just let him do it. Careful. Careful. Anything down here? Yep. Looks like there's one. Let's check our inventory. 2 more. 2 more. Okay. Grab this one. Okay, can we just... Careful. Careful. Grab the arrow. Why can't I grab the arrow? We can grab the arrow now. I had to cut down the entire tree just to do that. But hey, at least we can grab it now. Okay, let's see here. We can get some more arrows. There we go. So now let me do this. Let me save my game. Also, how many arrows do we have? 24. Okay. No! He got me. At least I saved my game. At least I saved my game. So I think I'm just going to end off this episode here. And in the next episode, we're going to go over to the Divine Beast. So thank you all so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you aren't already. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next episode. And I do want to eventually come back to here and actually take this dude down, because, you know, it's just gonna be at the back of my mind, like, I want to take this dude down, you know? It'd be very fun to do that. Anyways, yeah, I'm just gonna end off the episode here, so thanks for watching, everybody, and as always, I'll see you all in the next episode of The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. Bye, everybody.